It's been a journey. It's been an incredible journey, but yet there is still a journey left to go. And that journey includes you. And isn't that really wonderful? So I am sure you're all in suspense about what is this big project, right? Just imagine for a second. I've been working 12 years like you saw, and I could see the end. I could see I finally had done my Sistine Chapel. I had done my, though, I'm like Magna Carta, but you know, like more than me had done it, I had put together a team to get it done. And then how incredible it was. And I was exhausted, as you heard. There were so many struggles to overcome. And to know a little bit more of that journey is that when I had first started doing my stained glass, and I, let me see if I can adjust this a little bit. You know, like my speech at times is a little slow, but though, yes, understand. And so I have been, you know, like a lot better as I have worked on it and overcome. And so when I was, though, small in junior high school, there was one kid who teased me about my speech every day. He would tease me and tease me. And then one day I got so frustrated with him, I then went up to him and I took his arm and I snapped it. I broke it. And I got expelled from school. It's true. But I had to ask myself, will I let this, though, you know, like weakness slow me down? Or else, will I plow through it? Will I know that there are other ways that you can speak to the individual? And so that is what I did. And then, and so I asked my parents if I could turn their two-car garage, into an art glass studio. Now, at the time, my dad had just barely begun his own adventure on a amber direct marketing company, and he was just started his journey, and he said, I will do this for you. I will park out in the snow if you either do it or starve. And I thought, do it or starve? He said, you got to have like no way out just to make it happen. And so he helped me on that. He helped me on that. And then with the company that he then had helped start, he then before he passed away, he had a 180,000 people that he then worked with under him, and it was incredible. But for the first year, he worked the hardest I had ever seen anyone work in his life. And he sat at his desk on that phone about sharing the story about how to ignite a fire in others. And so that has helped me. And through this journey of roots of though knowledge, and I was in London on the bridge and looking out over that though water after I had walked these streets for like a couple hours, and I had recorded me walking under the bridge, and so I thought I could show you that, and then I could hear music playing. And it touched my soul. And this is what I had envisioned in my head. So let me see if I can play this video. So there's me working. And so this is where I was. Not there, but I was here. So I had walked over to here. And this is the vision that I had saw. Now, I took the picture, and then you can see what date it was, October the 24th, 2016. So it has been 5 years. And it has been an incredible 5 years. But this is the video. Let's see if... I saw this, and then I saw this. So the roots of humanity, the soul, I saw a way looking out over all of those, lights, and I could say we can illustrate the soul of humanity, or we can create the sphere of light, a sphere of light. And then I told thee, though, the universe, no, I can't do it. I can't do it. But then, what touched my heart, that if you make something out of your life, you are successful. If you help make others make something out of the life of the others, you are extremely successful. And the power of the visual image, right? The power of the visual image. And so throughout time, there has been such history that has been laid out with the image. And on the roots of knowledge, what I saw was the power of the currency or coin. And I then used that to help to educate. But then I saw this structure, and then inside of the structure, a magnificent piece of glass, or the Tree of Hope for Humanity. And then I saw all of the four elements, earth and water and fire and air. And so as you can see here, the structure with the inside, and then it is the world, and it is held up by seven columns. Seven columns, which though represent all seven continents, and then also the attributes and characteristics which make us the sphere of light within us. And so, thank you. And so let me go, and so this is the inside. And so inside will sit a flame. And so this flame here will sit inside a glass sculpture. And now the height of this is 80 feet high. And so, but it though doesn't have floors, it just has one floor as it spirals around. You never, and it's because we are all equal. We're all equal. So this flame that burns within you, right? And so, and then there it's the columns and structures. And we have already received donations. And then the land, it is going to be out at Thanksgiving Point, like Lehi, Utah. And so what I did with this idea, it is like such a big idea. Where do you start? How do you explain to people what are the characteristics and traits that will better themselves? And then we then, narrowed it down to the keywords. And these keywords here. And so they are the seven pillars of human values: is knowledge, creativity, and faith, and love, and unity, and freedom, and courage. And then under those fit how to heal the world. And so to do this big of a project, I needed to write a thesis art piece. And so I don't write, I speak in the visual images. And so this is where it began, of how to show that humanity beats the same heartbeat. And we have seen that through good and bad, right? About how the coronavirus has not that shown how much integral we are, really? And how connected we are. And so then we began to sketch our team of artists. And so this was the beginning. And then as we began to hone it and then work those. And then, but then as you sketch a piece of art, you feel if that is the best way to go. So sorry, I am going a little crazy on this little button here. So this right here, you see, it though has though humankind here and the earth and all of the roots of the past. But then our DNA is so connected and true that the imagery has to show the DNA. As you look deeper into a good piece of art that is a masterpiece, you will though learn more and find out more. That's what makes an incredible piece of art. And that's what I love about the imagery. And so you see the DNA now, a little sneak peek. The actual one all done is behind these curtains. Aren't you excited to see them? Yes. And so I am going to give you a sneak hints of what you'll see. And now it will still wow you and take your breath away. Okay, so as you can see on the top there, the fabric of humanity, or the DNA chain. So right at the crown of the window, there is the DNA, or human genome. See the AGTC? And then we chose the textiles and fabrics from around the world that has that DNA look to it. And it merges down and it turns into a ribbon. And then on that ribbon are marked the keywords. And there were some artists that said, we should put them all in English. Right? We should put them all in English. Yeah, so we can all understand. I said, well, really, for us all to understand, they need to be in many languages. Many languages. And then with the technology that we have, they can be translated. And it's a form of discovery. And so, yes. And so this ribbon, it comes down the fabric of humanity. It comes down with that ribbon, all of the characteristics, and that ribbon it mingles with the roots, and then those roots come together, and in these is also the tree of hope for humanity, and they blend, and then one of those roots goes into the earth and goes down into the earth and feeds into the umbilical cord of the future of us. And then you can see the hands, head, hands, and hearts as you dive in. Hands of the older generation of teaching the younger generation, and they are weaving a vessel out of the ribbon and the roots. This way. And now there, these windows, I will be so bold, is we want to build on that we are the 95% alike and only 5% different. And yes, and this lady here, the parable or allegory, you don't know if she is receiving the coin or if she is going to give it away or hand it, or if she is offering it up unto the universe, but she embraces the next generation. And now this one here is a scale, and see the scale. What is wrong with this scale? It is unbalanced. It's unbalanced, right? Now, if you notice, this is the round, but this is in the shape of a heart. This is in the shape of the heart. And so money is a good wholesome thing. It is amazing. But though Like money will make you more of what you already are. It is the great magnifier, and I really believe that. I really believe that. And so what is in your heart is the most important, and you can use your resources to do good. Yes. Thank you. Now, this story is one of my favorites. And so when I did the Roots of Knowledge, I thought, wouldn't it be great if I could get a piece of the moon and put it into the windows? And so I thought, how hard is it? How hard could this be? A piece of the moon, that can't be that difficult, right? And so I then reached out to the NASA, and they're all, no, you can't have any part of it. You can't have anything. They're all in a big vault. And I tried and tried, and I spoke to my congressman. And he said, I don't know what I can do much for you on that one, so I didn't get to be able to put a piece of the moon in the window. Now, though, knowledge is a powerful thing, right? Once you understand something, what though you thought was impossible, hard to attain, it can become reality. And so, what I discovered is NASA, when they collected moon rocks, when they studied them they found a piece of the earth on the moon. So when an asteroid hits moon, hunks of moon will come up and they will start to circulate. And then moon meteorite will then come down to earth. And so I then tracked down one of these meteorites. Yes, I tracked down one of these meteorites, and with clear cut crystal. So this has a piece of the moon in it. Today, when you actually touch the windows, you can say, I have feet on the ground, but my arm is reaching for the moon. Yes? Yes, it is. Absolutely. But then I thought, if that happened to the moon, what else did it happen to? And so here is Mars, our rover. And so there are also artifacts on this earth. Very rare. I got a piece of Mars. A piece of Mars is sitting right there. And so you can say to yourself, I am not only going to touch the moon, but I'm going to keep on going, right? I'm going to keep on going. So, and in there is lots of other artifacts. Now my dad, he buried into my soul, show the light, be the light. And so my mom, even though my dad is gone, she still gets a check every day from the company that he helped to start. Isn't that an amazing thing? Amazing thing. Amazing thing. On his headstone, and then he traveled all over the world, spoke to countless people. On his headstone, he wanted etched on there, a candle will lose no light by lighting another candle. Yes, yes. You will lose no light by lighting another one. And as you can see here, look at the match. Look at the shadow of the flame. It is not there. And this right here, what I have discovered with light. And so in this massive piece of glass that I made, see that beautiful thing? This made this, a prism. And so can you paint with light and take the light and then I'm like manipulate it. And so on these windows, you will see northern lights. And as you move, they will change. They will change. And it just isn't me entering into your mind the power of suggestion. Or is it? I don't know. You'll have to see. Okay, now. So, I am going to go, I don't know how to. So, we are going to share, I lost my earpiece. And so my ear, and so this is a whole new ear, actually, because I had those skin grafts, but that can't slow me down, right? No, nothing can slow you down. So as I could stand up here and speak all day, but I got to show you these windows, right? But before that, I really wanted to show and express how I am nobody special. I'm not. I believe that no matter who you are, where you are, or where you come from, you have moments of genius. You have moments of genius, all of you. Here's the trick. Do you act upon it? Do you act upon those? Or are those ideas at times like so big and scary that you hold it in and say, oh, you know, like what if people laugh at this idea, or else what if it gets misused or else rampled? You know, if your dreams don't scare you, they are not big enough. I promise you that. Yes. And so my wife, who could not be here today, she wrote a book that shares the journey of humanity in a nice educational level. And who will read this is my beautiful daughter Victoria Holdman. So if she could come up to the stage with a round of applause. Woo!
Hello. Okay, cool. Do you maybe want to hold it while I
Yes.
Do it?
Yes.
Okay. And so. Do we want to sit and want to stand?
Let's sit down.
Let's sit. Let's have a chat.
We can have a little. And then we got to use the clicker.
Oh, yeah. Let's do the clicker as well.
Yeah, but you can do the clicker. There we go.
Thank you, Blake. Can you guys hear me okay? Yeah. I kind of have a quiet voice, so I'll try to talk loud. Okay, the piece that is you. The world's a big place. It's easy to ask, where do I fit in? What might be my task? There was a boy who had these questions too. Look at what he was inspired to do. He struggled to speak when he was still small. At times, the boy could not say much at all. It was hard. It hurt when he was ignored, but there were more ways to speak, he explored. If words did not work to add to his part, then he would say what he wanted through art. Sorry, not yet. And that's what he did each day of his life. Art helped him to speak and lessened the strife. One day, on a bench in front of a school, He got an idea so huge, big, and cool. It was ginormous, a supersized dream. Now he would need a remarkable team. It was way too big to do on his own. It would be better if he weren't alone. Artists and scholars and painters of glass all helped get it done, and it was a blast. Working with others, his dream came to be. Roots of Knowledge is finished. What is it? Let's see. The best part. It's a huge stained glass window, an entire wall, 60,000 plus pieces. We've counted them all. The artist made it in order to show all of the amazing things humans can know. It's filled with events, people, and places. You may or may not know some of the faces. It has math and science, music and dance, those who were willing to go take a chance. So much to find. There are coins, trees, and birds, and quotes that show the great power of words. And people from all over the world, see? They're not that different from you or from me. Lincoln brought freedom and a country together. Clark and Lewis explored whatever the weather. Ruth's chocolate chip cookie, a treat to take along. Joan of Arc, oh so faithful, courageous, and strong. Shelley and Shakespeare, Doyle and Austin. Stories to be read and enjoyed often. Merchant ships traveled with their heavy load. And why is that chicken there crossing the road? Gandhi, Lala, and hundreds more waiting for you to discover, explore. Confucius and Plato both thought about light and how happiness comes from doing what's right. Tom Edison holds a star from Van Gogh. There's Sesame Street and the places you'll go. Da Vinci, Mandela, and others from history took their place in this world full of wonder and mystery. Each made a difference. There's a place where they fit. It might have been hard, but not one of them quit. You're unique in this life. There's a spot just for you. Never forget all the good you can do. Like these pieces of glass, your color and size matter less than if you are someone who tries. Every piece of the window is different. It's true. Big or small, each one matters. It's needed, like you. We all have talents. We all have a gift. Find ways to use yours to build and uplift. Always be kind and work hard. Do your best. Your life can brighten the lives of the rest. Something awesome can come from what you do too. The world will be blessed by the peace that is you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thanks. I love you. Thank you. All right. I'm taking off the jacket. Things are getting serious here. So this is the first, you are the first ones to experience as in-depth the journey that we've been on for the past 5 years. And then when I stood on that bridge and this idea came from the on the universe, and then on the next slide, let's show the building. There we go. When it came down, I didn't want it. I was pushing it back. But then it touched my soul and my heart. And what came over me is, this is just not your journey, Tom. This is just not your journey. This is the journey of those that you love and that others love. And can you illustrate and hit home to others as you do these little acts and remember these things, and it will change. Picture is worth 1,000 words, then 1,000 pictures is worth 1,000,000 words. And who is going to spread those those thousand pictures, those thousand images that will uplift and touch hearts, where they need to go, that is you. And so let me reintroduce Blake Davis.
All right, y'all, you guys ready to see these? Okay, we're going to start from inside. Let's stay up here with me, Tom. You guys start from the inside. You're going to pull the first card. You guys ready to see them? It's killing you. All right, let's go on the inside window. Start pulling very ever so gently. And let's unveil two of the six inside this room. You may be wondering, where's the seventh? Maybe you saw it last night. Let's go ahead and start on the middle. Go ahead, Wayne. Yeah, get yours done. And then Angela, go ahead and start. As you can imagine, we don't want to break them.
So you see the fabric up on the top and how he is planting the tree of hope for humanity. And others are helping with the water and the soil.
What do you guys think?
And so what I like is the moment that you couldn't even speak or applaud. It's just that like moment of the internalization in your heart. Thank you.
I'm just letting it sit for a minute.
Yes, thank you.
If you're at home in your living room, we always say, when you come to an event, you can feel it. Hopefully you can feel this too in your living room. If you can't, there'll be a point where you'll be able to feel it in your living room. So, okay. So Tom, come here for just a second. You guys, I have to tell Code. Yeah, right. I have to tell you guys something. So, first of all, what a pleasure it has been to get to know Tom.
Thank you.
This has been a long journey to get to this point. For Tom, obviously, you heard his story. For us at 7K, and we were presented this opportunity, and we learned about it. It's also been a long journey to get to this point, right? Mm-hmm. For us, with Tom and the other team that was involved. And with that being said, though, today, well, I got to tell you, when we first met Tom, he had his wife, his sidekick, right? Like true sidekick, telling us, walking us through the roots of humanity windows. And Gail said it in the documentary. No, I think Tori said it in the documentary, or TJ. I got too much in my head. I think it was TJ, the son, said that Gail is his mouthpiece, right? And you can see that in the documentary. Unfortunately, she couldn't be here today. Last minute things came up. I don't think it was meant to be. And that's not taking anything away from Gail, but please give it up for Tom standing up here delivering this today. And by the way, I get lessons from Tom every time I speak to him, as you can tell, right? But one of the lessons that I got today was when he was talking about the building and he was talking about the roots of humanity and the soul. By the way, soul in Spanish, perfect. Okay. So, double meaning there with the name, right? When he was talking about that building, like for a minute I went, wait, is it already built? Did you guys think that?
Yeah, right.
Did you catch that? I promise you, it is not built yet. But in Tom's head, It's built. He was talking about the flame. How tall is the flame? Does anyone remember? He said it is 80 feet. He didn't say it's going to be. Catch that? Powerful, right? I can feel it running through me right now, right? How important of a lesson is that? And how much confidence does that give you that Tom is going to finish that? Right? Amen. So with that, that was pretty cool. Okay, you guys ready for lunch? Oh, man. Oh, we just brought you here to show you the cool windows. That's it. Okay. Tom and I want to introduce you to one more step here, okay?
And with that, what he is about, to share is the light. What I saw was the earth, and then we are making the earth, but we are making the sphere of light. It is us that is the light. Without it, it is only a sphere, just like a billions of those spheres out there. We are the ones that are the light. And this is how we'll spread it. So here we go. Yes.
So the problem with the building... Sorry, Tom.
No problem.
The problem with the building is that not all 6 billion people on the planet are going to be able to come visit that thing. There's a lot of constraints to that, right? Now, the beauty is that there's going to be millions and millions and millions of people that are going to flow through that thing. What about the rest? How can we tell that story? How can we give it to them? How can we bring it to them, right? And so this is how we feel like we would like to help as a company, and how we're hoping that you also would like to help, one, be the light, okay, and two, make sure that this message and these windows and Tom's art get to every living room on the planet. Introducing one more step.
There's so much that divides the human family. But what is it that unites us?
What are the events, the experiences, the tools we all have in common? Those common threads that transcend culture, race, geography, and time to touch the lives of every human being.
Introducing one of the truly stunning works of art preserved on gold notes, the Unity Panel. As one of the 7 main pillars in the Roots of Humanity project, by celebrated stained glass artist, Tom Holdman.
From inventions to historic events to the foods we eat, the Unity Panel explores the roots of humanity that unite us. Inside this gorgeous note, you'll find vignettes of the human experience to which we can all relate.
The International Space Station serves as a powerful symbol of the human drive to explore the universe and the uniting of countries to do so.
The human capacity for forgiveness is portrayed in the forefront of the panel, serving as a reminder that unity can only be achieved when grievances are set aside.
Even the COVID-19 virus is shown, reminding us of our shared experience as the entire world has struggled to help one another understand and overcome a dangerous threat.
There are over 20 symbolic scenes depicted in the Unity Panel that show the power of focusing on how we are the same, that empathy can be stronger than fear. Explore it for yourself as you collect the whole series,
The Roots of Humanity.
So this first note, we highlighted humanity in this video, right? Give me one more click there, Cole. One more on that one. Thank you. The first one we highlighted is unity, right? We wanted to make that the showcase for this particular event because of all the divisiveness, right? And the goal that Tom and his wife, and by the way, when you meet Gail, you will completely understand that this is not just Tom's work.
Absolutely.
Gail is a saint, I will tell you. getting emotional because I met her. Their souls are interlaced in every piece of this story. And what he said was 95% of us is the same. If you look at a DNA strand, 95% of it is indistinguishable from another. 5% is different. So how in the world can we help everyone understand that we're 95% the same? How can we unify? How can we help spread empathy? Starts with us, right? I'll tell you a story. Last night, I walked out of the restaurant after working on this, right? How impactful is this, by the way? This is on my mind. Think about this. I walked out of a restaurant last night, and I saw some individuals. Oh, you talked about embracing the next generation, right? I'm a millennial. You guys are like millennials, blah, right? And I look at Gen Z, and I'm like, Gen Z, blah, right? Well, look, it was apparent last night. They were dressed differently than me, okay? And I walked by, and the first thought that came to my mind was a judgmental one, naturally. And then I went, Blake, what are you doing? You've been working on this for months. They're the same as you. They're the same. They just have different clothes on, right? They might disagree with you on a lot of things. That's okay. It's only 5%. So the big goal here is not to help Tom build a building. The big umbrella goal is how do we unify the world? The building's just a symbol of it.
You.
So to start, we want to start with five notes. Okay, five of the seven. No coin drop today. Something better, in my opinion. Something much, much better. Tom, I would like to hear from you really quickly. You talk so much about light and how important the light is to the windows, to making them work, right? If we turn the lights off from the windows, they're not as stunning. They're not stunning at all, in fact, right? So you turn the light on and it works. We can't make light come through gold notes, Tom. Mm-hmm. But that part is so important to you. Why in the world would you allow us to put these on gold notes?
So let's see if this works here. With these months of talking through this, and how to print this, you can see that a photograph will like never do this justice, right? Because of it's though how as the light changes and comes through it, it will change and then alter. And so on a piece of gold that is reflective as well, it does like shimmer and change. And so all of the threads of that like link, all of the threads are also what encompasses every piece of glass in there, and in here they are all the black, but though can we make those threads out of gold? And so that is what we did. We changed all of the black lines to gold.
Thank you. And I'll tell you, it was no small feat to make those windows. It was also no small feat to make these gold notes work. This is something that has never been done like this before. The work of an ex-Disney animation artist helped to be able to get them to this point. Work from a lot of different people that cared a lot about making sure that these notes turned out how they did, and I feel like they're in the best possible place they can be, which was super important because we have, 18 years of work already done that we have to make sure we justify. We got to make sure it's right, and I think that we nailed it. I hope Tom feels like that we nailed it as well. So with that being said, you guys, this is how we're going to do this. We told you we would introduce a brand new autosaver option. Better than a coin drop, right? Way better. Look, because if we want the big goal to happen, we can't just do it once. We can't just drop this once. This has to be a really, really long-term project. And do you see all of the different ideas that could come out of these pillars, right? And all the future work that Tom will create? How long we could tell this story in so many different ways to so many different people? That's why it will be a brand new autosaver option. Actually, let me rephrase that. I'll take my own lesson. That's why it is a brand new autosaver option. In fact, it will be $115 and 15 points. And if everything went really well while I was up here, it's live. So go now, what you will find. So everyone that's brand new, go to your account, go to your autosaver page. Don't break the internet. Go ahead, Cole. What you're gonna notice, we've revamped the autosaver just a little bit, okay? So we've changed some of the names in the autosaver. It's not live. Didn't go well. Do things always go well, Tom?
They don't always go well, man. I mean, I have snapped a few pieces of glass in my life.
And arms, apparently.
And arms, yeah. Yes.
So it will be live shortly. Let's see if I got any text updates here. So go ahead, and you can now choose the Seven Pillars Gold Notes as your monthly autosaver. As the one that you prefer, or the next one that you prefer, because I know many of you get all of these now. So you'll notice we changed the names of these. Okay, it's no longer basic, right? Variety and specialty. Now it will describe. Now look at this is like telling into the future. As we grow, so shall this, right? So the options and offerings inside of the autosaver has two as well. And so the names now will reflect kind of what the collection is that's currently being sent. Okay. You guys good with that? Better than a coin drop? All right, you guys. Tom, give one more round of applause for Tom, please.
Thank you.
Standing. Thank you. Stand up. Thank you, Tom.
Thank you.